in the circle of life. It's a wheel of fortune. It's a leap of faith. It's a band of hope. Till we find our place. In the circle, the circle of life. Some of us fall by the wayside, and some of us soar to the stars, and some of us sail through our troubles, and some have to live with the scars. There's far too much to take in here, more to find than could ever be found. But the sun rolling high in the sapphire sky keeps great and small on the endless round. In the circle of life, it's a wheel of fortune. It's a leap of faith. It's a band of hope. Till we find a way on the path of winding. Yeah. In the sun.
Winston-Salem Civil Air Patrol, plead the fifth. Let's give everyone a big hand. There's some additional folks we would like to thank for coming out today and participating. The Boy Scouts, the Honda Flying Club, without whom this would not be possible. Woody Cahill and AOPA. Tim Clifford, RAF board member, again, plead the fifth. Robert Logan, one of our jumpers, yay. Chris Davis, the other jumper. And then we had to have someone flying the helicopter. That's Jared. Thank you, Jared. The Sugar Valley Craftsman, California Fresh Catering for our lunch. I'm sorry if we missed anybody, but all the other volunteers that made this possible. Thank you so much. And now we would like to introduce a special person to Davie County. She's done so much to promote this beautiful area that we're standing in today. And she has a great background in aviation. Her husband's a commercial pilot, and both of her parents were involved in aviation. And she actually worked at an FBO in college in Madison, Connecticut. So without further ado, I want to introduce a very special lady, the president of the Davie County Chamber of Commerce, Carolyn McManamy.
Thank you, Julia. Well, first I want to welcome everyone to Sugar Valley Airport, and for our visitors, welcome to Davie County. I'm thrilled that we have such a beautiful day today and that the weather held off for us. I think we're all very blessed to have Sugar Valley Airport here in Davie County, and I think we are thankful for the tremendous commitment of the stewards whose vision is to see this beautiful facility shine, not only as an outstanding destination for the recreation flying community, but as a special gathering place and a resource for everyone to enjoy. Sugar Valley is an integral part of Davie County Recreation. While its roots are firmly planted in all things aviation, it is also a special place that cultivates teaching and learning of crafts and skills. It is also a special place for relationships to develop and to be nurtured so that they may grow into lasting friendships. With Sugar Valley encompassing so very much, it seems only fitting that a friendship fire circle would be created as a central gathering point that provides warmth, friendship, and camaraderie to all who meet here. The placement of the fire circle at the edge of this lake offers the sweeping views of this beautiful land and an opportunity to enjoy the very essence of the Sugar Valley Airport. To the many volunteers and friends of Sugar Valley, I congratulate you. I congratulate you on your vision and your hard work that bring us here today. It is a great day in Davie County when we stand together with all of you and share in the celebration that you have accomplished so much and that this dedication of your beautiful fire circle may happen. So I thank you for letting me be a part of this. It's wonderful to be here. Thank you and congratulations.
Thank you, Carolyn. The kind words, and it is a wonderful show of friendship. We'll introduce our airport manager, Thomas White.
Is everybody having a good time? Good. Hey. You know, sometimes things are just meant to be, but you know, before they happen, you don't know that they're meant to be. And this fire circle is an example of one of those things. You know, people ask us, why would a nonprofit own an airport? Well, we didn't know that there was going to be a fire circle here, but we were walking down the road one day and this guy comes in and says, hey, why don't you guys put a fire circle out there? We said, well, that sounds like a good idea, let's do it. Well, little did we know that 7,000 bricks later it would actually happen. And the purpose, as Carolyn said, of this fire circle is not just to promote aviation, it's to promote people getting together, having a good time, being friends with one another. You know, we all came together today around aviation or having a good time, and some of you may have actually been attracted here by free lunch, but you came, and I'll bet you haven't had any arguments about politics or religion or anything else. You've just had a good time, haven't you? And that's what this place is for. It's for us to come and have a good time, to engage in fellowship, to develop relationships, and we invite you to use it. Tonight, there will be Boy Scouts camping here. Next weekend, there will be Honda Flying Club camping here. In June, there will be the Winston-Salem Squadron of the Civil Air Patrol camping here. There, others have just come out and sat on the picnic benches and drink a cup of water and watch the airplanes take off and land. All of those are proper activities for Sugar Valley Airport. And we hope that you have given us your contact information so that you can be notified of other activities. For example, some of you saw the teaser to the Millionaires Unit today. Those guys have promised that when that gets finished, they're going to let Sugar Valley Airport show it, and we want you to be here when it happens. So keep in touch, and those are the types of activities that we want to promote. Now, there are a couple of people whose names I want to mention today, because they have been instrumental. You see, HFCSVA, Honda Flying Club, Sugar Valley Airport. That's a partnership. And the Honda Flying Club has been instrumental in getting this off the ground here, so to speak, this fire circle and the patio and everything that goes with it. Mike Smith, in the red shirt over here in the corner, took responsibility for primarily designing and laying it out and helping build this thing. He himself built this pit practically by himself. And of the 7,000 plus bricks, he laid most of them by hand every Saturday, every Sunday since November, practically. And all of this was done by volunteers. There was no paid staff, no paid contractors. Nobody came by virtue of pay to come here and work. It was not all Honda volunteers, Sugar Valley volunteers. And then we have all the people who bought bricks, and we hope you will join them. And he had to leave a few minutes ago, but I couldn't help but bring a tear to my eye when Claude Burkhead, 85, saw his brick donated by his daughter. He was overjoyed. And we hope that you will memorialize your friends and loved ones in the same way, and your organizations. The second person I want to mention is the president of the Honda Flying Club, whose name is John Wells, standing in the corner over here. John woke up. He came to our fly-in in October. Within a week or two, he found that 3 o'clock in the morning, one that morning, he couldn't sleep. He woke up with the thing that makes the world go around, an idea. And the idea was to have a fire circle here at Sugar Valley Airport. And so he gets up and he makes this wonderful PowerPoint presentation that he emails to us. Not only did it have a layout of a fire circle, but even already had it laid out that we could raise money by selling bricks. All of that was laid out in one inspiration at 3 o'clock in the morning. And I'm going to let him pick up the story there. John?
Thanks, Thomas. It kind of happened that way. I had an opportunity. I've been flying about 20 years, and I had an opportunity to take a program in North Carolina and fly to all the airports. But this airport wasn't on the list because it wasn't a public airport. And so one day last year, I saw this flyer about it having a fly-in here. So I flew in here, and I told the flying club members, hey, there's this fly-in over Sugar Valley. Never been there. Make sure your short field landing skills are up to speed, as you noticed, and let's go over there. So I flew in here and I said, boy, I've had a chance to fly all over the country. I've flown in the backcountry of Idaho with my family. I've gone to these backcountry strips, and this is probably one of the most tremendous places I've ever seen, having the opportunity with the lake and the camping. And all these ideas started flowing in my head. But I said, okay, and I went on my way. Next thing I know, I get a phone call from Thomas saying, hey, would you come over and talk to us about some ideas? And I came over, and the first idea was trying to do a camporee for the scouts, an aviation camporee. And that night I went home because I was trying to think of ideas of how to make it grow. And as Thomas said, it was about 2 or 3 in the morning, and this idea came up in my head. And I said, if I don't write it down when I wake up, I'll probably forget I even thought of it. So I got up, I wrote it down, and the next day I did this PowerPoint, like you said, and I sent it to him. And I got to tell you, it's not so much as what was on paper, but what transpired here. I've never seen an organization that can act so quickly as this airport. By the time I had presented to them, I came back, we kind of walked the area. The very next week I come out here, the ground's graded. They're already starting to prepare stuff. And so I'm thinking in my head, and you probably had this before too, where you have this large, grandiose idea in your head, and if you really go out and do it, next thing is, oh boy, can I finish it? You know, you're thinking, now what have I done? And I didn't tell them that till today, but I was thinking, oh boy, I don't know if we'll ever get this thing done. But then I started getting people involved, and I gotta tell you, they really stepped up. And what this really symbolizes is the volunteerism, the unity that people put together can do this. As he said, there was no architect. There was no contract labor. It was all a labor of love, of spirit that resides here. And I think the biggest thing, as Carolyn said, is it's for the whole community. We want people to use it. And so over the time, over those last months, I really want to give a thanks to all the people from Sugar Valley who contribute to this, as well as the Honda Flying Club. And like I said, Mike and Jeff, where's Jeff? Where are you at, Jeff? Jeff's back there. We're all part of the Honda Aircraft Company. We had really no place to go. Obviously, you're not going to build something like this at Piedmont Triad, okay? TSA probably won't let that happen. But we found an airport that we could hang out, and this is where it all happened. And these guys made this really happen, and they were out here every weekend. We had a little setback at one time. We had a pretty good rainstorm, and the bricks that weren't quite sanded in yet kind of washed out and back to the drawing board. And it is here today to show you what can happen. And I want to really thank everybody who contributed to get this done. This was a vision, and this is a vision that came true. So just think in your heads in the many months and years to come is that you can be out here as a fire circle and gather around that fire circle, tell stories, and have fun with that. But again, my hat's off to this airport. They really epitomize it, really shows you what modern, what aviation is all about from the old days to the new days, and how general aviation needs to be. This is really a truly outstanding airport, and I think all of us can see that today, and my hat's off to Thomas and your crew. Thank you so much.
Thank you, John. So whenever we get those ideas in the middle of the night, let's write them down, because this was a great one. So let's all celebrate the lighting of the fire. Will our torch bearers come forward, please?
Step into the sun. There's more to be seen than could ever be seen. More to do than could ever be done.